is Smita and you're watching Rendezvous with Smita Kumar. Today we are speaking to Manu Kohli, CEO Cogniable, which is an AI-driven platform for autism and associated disorders. Manu has over 16 years of global SAP implementation and data analytics experience spread across Europe, India and USA. Hi Manu, welcome to MediCircle.
Hello Smita, hi. Thank you so much for inviting me here.
So Manu, tell us more about Cogniable.
Okay, at Cogniable, we are developing artificial intelligence based solutions for early detection and then intervention of children with the autism spectrum disorder. Autism is like an epidemic. I think before Corona, it was seriously in a big limelight. And it is impacting right now every 1.5 to 2 children out of 100. To make sure that you manage the autism very well, you need to detect children very early. So detection means that every child that is born needs to be checked if he's growing properly and he doesn't have the symptoms of autism or any other neurodevelopmental delay. And the population in India for newborn every year is 18 million children. So you cannot screen 18 million children. You cannot check 18 million children per year unless you have a technology-based solution. So what we are doing is we have given the observation power of detecting the child's growth, especially on autism features, to artificial intelligence based model, where a parent is interacting with a child or any caregiver is interacting with a child in a natural setting. And that session is video recorded. And then that video is analyzed by an AI engine. And it suggests that, if the child is on a risk of autism or not. And then if there is a it delayed observed or there is some kind of features that are detected, you can start intervention services immediately from any remote location through a click of a button on a mobile phone. And then those services are very affordable, accessible. It comes with the complete protocol assessment, plans, all digital in nature and all remotely executed.
Oh, that's great. So what was the idea or incident that laid the foundation of Cogniable?
Yes, there were two things. Firstly, my wife is a special educator. When we got married, I had a chance to see special needs children. And that was something, I never had experienced that kind of children, never seen them before. So that was something, first thing, we got married in 2002. And the second one was after 6 years of marriage, we recognized that our child was also on a neurodevelopmental delay. And his, detection was delayed because of some unforeseen reasons. But then that really motivated us to, start something which can be meaningful for a lot of other parents like us who do not have those support services available.
So Cogniable is founded by researchers and scientists from IIT Delhi, pediatricians, psychologists, and BCBAs from India and USA. How is it providing affordable, accessible, and high quality management on autism condition?
For us to make that kind of solution that has a global impact and that has a meaningful scientific validation, you really need to have the academic pediatricians and academic scientists behind it to do that. So to do that, I also started my PhD at IIT Delhi after I returned to India, and my PhD is focused on this topic only. So that was the first thing. Secondly, I was very fortunate to get in touch with a few scientists and few professors at IIT Delhi in artificial intelligence, with whom we really piloted the solution initially and saw a lot of success. We then went to the government and said that this is our pilot, these are our results, which are very encouraging. And government was very generous and supportive of our cause to really fund us a big clinical trial in which we really got hold of some of our partners like Dr. Monica Juneja from Maulana Azad Medical College, who is somebody with comes with a lot of experience in autism world. And then, another co-founder I got was from the US, Dr. Josh, who runs multiple autism centers there. So it was a team that we built over stitched over a period of time in this complete process. And currently our solutions are under clinical trial, and our market price, once we take them, would be, you know, for detection, it can be done in less than 200 rupees. So it's going to be a really, really cost saving for parents who think of it like this, that there are parents and families who come from Bihar, Odisha, Patna, Northeast, come to Delhi for getting their child checked. They spend thousands of rupees, multiple, you know, sittings they have to go to a pediatrician and get their children checked. All this can happen now virtually, especially with Corona, more and more virtualization and digital healthcare is anyways coming. So, and you can do it at a very affordable cost. And the same thing is for intervention as well, because intervention usually costs 30 to 40,000 rupees a month, right? Our tool, they probably will drop to 1,000 to 1,500 rupees a month. So that's the you know, reduction of the cost reduction and the quality we are bringing in. And then the parent's data is going to drive, the child's data is going to drive his therapy, which is the most unique thing about it.
Okay. So I think that's a great cost reduction in terms of, see, people traveling from tier 2, tier 3 cities to all these metros just for their treatment of kids. It's really, really difficult. Both it's time consuming. Also, it is, there are so many parents who actually cannot afford. For them, I think it's like a boon to have such a...
Yeah, absolutely.
So as we move towards the future, IT and AI seems to be the future of healthcare. So what are your thoughts on the same? Because whatever you have developed, it is IT and AI driven. It has been, and it has reformed the way we used to see solutions, medical solutions. So what is your take on that?
Yeah, I think it is inevitable. The technology and artificial intelligence coming into education and healthcare, I think these are two sectors which really needs a technology transformation because of its limited access and also because of the cost. I think these two sectors are really going to see a lot of focus and introduction of technology like artificial intelligence. And especially after COVID, the COVID has really accelerated the adoption of this process. Because right now we have experienced this, that digitally we can work remotely. Digital healthcare is something we are trying to experience every day. It's through the traditional means of telehealth, but I think once you start, you know, bringing in the database decision making into telehealth, that's going to be a game changer for the coming things. So I think it's not only the the traditional healthcare like fever, but the traditional healthcare issues like fever or cough. But the mental health issues like what we are trying to solve now, like depression or autism or, dementia, schizophrenia, these are all going to be probably handled and artificial intelligence will have a very large role to play in here.
Sure. Thank you so much, Manu, for joining us in our talk show with you. The most important thing, what I found on autism is that there is so much information on Google, but there is not that clarity. There are some very good community centers and medical institutions in the developed countries like US and UK, where they are having these programs for detection, then the programs for intervention and further development of the child. But I think in case of India, we are a little bit lagging behind in the terms of detection also, in the terms of early intervention also. So I think your technology and the way you are treating it is really, really great for those people extremely who are not actually finding any solution. I think if you talk about Mumbai, at least you still get good medical centers, but in tier 2, tier 3 cities, they generally take autism in a very different way. I think it's a differently style, but he or she has got their own superpowers. So I think that has to be understood and taken care of. So I think you guys are doing a very, very great job. So thank you so much for coming and sharing your thoughts, such insightful thoughts with us.
Thank you, Smita. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure.